Chapter 21, Budgetary Control. Part 1. Now in Chapter 20, we learn how a manager puts together a budget, planning for the coming year. Now in Chapter 21, we're going to look at how we use the budget to control. Control is a major part of management operations. And the way we do that is we produce budget reports, which compares the actual results achieved with the planned objectives. Now, the planned objectives were laid down in the master budget. The actual results now are happening as we go through the year. The accounting is accumulating the actual sales and the actual costs. Produces a report for the manager, and if there's a large difference, then the manager is able to take corrective action. So these reports are done either on a weekly or a monthly basis. For example, a sales report would be done weekly, and it would compare the sales goals to what we thought, what we actually achieved. This report would go to senior management. All government or all departmental managers would receive a departmental overhead cost report, probably monthly. And the manager had predicted what his costs would be in the coming year. And now he's going to get a report that says these are his actual costs compared to what he predicted. And that would help him then determine whether he needs to do corrective action. The thing is, now we're comparing what actually happened to the budget, master budget level of activity that we developed in the previous chapter. And that is called the static activity because it's got one level. Now, it's okay if we're talking sales, because here we have, for example, the sales manager predicting 180,000 sales budgeted the first quarter, 210 the second quarter. Actually, what happened is they achieved 179 in the first quarter, 199.5 in the second quarter. So looking at it a little closer then, we look at the first quarter that ended March 31st. He budgeted 150. Actual was 179. The difference between the budget and the actual is $1,000. Now, the actual came in to be $1,000 less than what he had predicted in the sales budget, so we say that that's unfavorable. Now, this difference we refer to as a variance. That's what we call it. And we indicate whether the variance is favorable or unfavorable for us. Now, this is under budget, so therefore it's unfavorable. But the next thing we do is we look at the size of that variance. We take 1,000 over 180,000 times 100%, and we see that it is only 1%. We're only out 1% on this estimate, and that's pretty good. I mean, we can't predict right on, so this is not a significant variance. Well, we call that an immaterial variance. Now, looking at the second quarter, we predicted 210, we came in at 199.5, which means we have a 10,500 variance. And again, we did not achieve budget, so therefore it is unfavorable. 10,500 as a percentage of 210,000 is 5% below budget. Well, this is significant. We say this is a material difference. There must be a reason why we're so far out. I mean, it's not that we did a poor job predicting. Something must have happened that caused us to be that far out. So that's what we say. We have to look into it. It merits investigation. We begin asking the sales manager what happened, and we look at ways in which we can fix this. Well, that's how we do it with the sales budget. Now, for sales, that's fine. We can use the static budget to compare against actual. But when we're talking costs, you keep in mind we have two types of costs, fixed and variable. Now, a fixed cost is going to be the same whether we produce 9,000, 10,000, or 11,000 units. But you see, a variable cost will vary according to the level of production or sales. And so therefore, we have a problem using the static budget to compare costs. What we develop is what are called flexible budgets. That is, budgets at different levels of activity. For example, let's take manufacturing overhead budget, which is a static budget, forging department for the year ended December 31st. We said that the budget production in units was going to be 10,000. At that level of activity, the cost for indirect materials would be 250, indirect labor 260, utilities 190, depreciation 280, property tax and supervision. So we said we were going to spend 1,100,000. What actually happened? We spent 1,232,000. We spent 132 more than we thought in the budget. For indirect materials, we thought we were going to spend 250, we spent 295. The variance is 45,000, and that is unfavorable. It's unfavorable here because we spent more than we thought. Indirect labor, we spent 52,000 more than we thought, so that too is unfavorable. Utilities, 35,000. Depreciation, property tax, and supervision were all the same. So basically, we're out over 12%. So you would say that this manager did not do a very good job. But there's a problem here. And the problem is we are comparing activity, the costs at one activity, the budget at 10,000 versus actual at 12,000. Well, when you look at the costs, you know, this is a variable cost. So it's going to vary in total in direct proportion to changes in the level of activity. So we would expect it to increase. Same with the direct labor, we would expect that to increase. Same with utilities. So we now look at how did we build the budget at 10,000? Well, obviously, we thought that the indirect materials were going to be $25 per unit, so we thought 250,000. The indirect labor was going to be $26 per unit. How we got that is we took the 260 divided by 10,000 units. Utilities, the same thing. So we got the unit costs. Now we know that these are variable unit costs. They're going to stay the same per unit. But if I produce more units, the cost in total is going to go up. What would the cost be at 12,000? Well, we would predict now that it would be 300,000 for indirect materials. $25 times 12,000. For indirect labor, it'd be 312. And for utilities, 228. So now, the manufacturing overhead budget report can be produced, and it's flexible. Flexible means that the budget has been redone at the same level as what we actually achieved. And so therefore, now we can compare the costs on an even basis. We said indirect materials at 12,000 should be 300,000, but it come in at 295, a variance of 5,000, and this is favorable. The manager did do a good job of controlling indirect materials. Indirect labor, no variance at all, so that is good. Utilities, again, a favorable 3,000. He spent 3,000 less. In fact, the total cost at 12,000 should have been 1,240,000. It came in at 1,232,000, which is 8,000 favorable. So the manager did a very good job with this budget. And so we have to now develop, for budgeting control, we have to develop what are called flexible budgets. And to do that, we look at the relevant range of activity, because within the relevant range, the fixed costs will not change. Then we identify the variable costs and determine the variable cost per unit of activity for each cost. Then we identify the fixed costs, and they're not going to change. And then we prepare the budget at selected levels.